Okay, let's look at parsing text with Rust. And first thing I want to do is convert this string with the new line characters and the at symbols. I want to convert that into a list of name and then the value, so key value. So we're going to iterate over the string if section. We'll say if it starts with then the pattern, so that's going to be the bit there we're going to skip over because we're going to use skip in a second. Many thanks to dot dot dot. Then curly braces. Then we'll let the author, so we'll pretend they're like an author of a book or something. So we'll say if it starts with that, then we're going to iterate over them. So for author in the section, dot lines, because we've got multiple lines, because we've got the new line character. Then we'll skip first element, which is the one we don't want, which is the many thanks to. Now we're inside our for loop, so we're just going to do the thing that we want to do on each of the items. So then we can say let author equal author. And then we'll trim, we want to trim off on each of those. We want to trim start. Trim start matches. Trim. Yes, start matches. Then we'll remove the hyphen space at. So that gives us an author object. And then, just try and print that. See what happens. Yeah, there we go. We could have had a case where we had some blank lines. Then we would have just had to check whether the author is empty or not. If not author is empty, then we would have done that. So we could still put that in. If not author dot is empty. Just gonna add another lot of curly braces. Just didn't dent that. I know it's not it's not fussy, but there we go, format it. Yeah, that's better. So if we had some blank lines in between here, it would handle that. So that's fairly conventional. Let's think about how we could do it with functional programming. So instead, we want to just build it up using the dot o. What's that? Let's do 7DD. Let's get rid of that. So we'll still have a section, but let's go for let authors equal. We're gonna make it so we're gonna have a vec of strings that we'll print at the end. So vec. then we'll work on section. And this is quite nice because you can just go lines, skip, similar to what we did before. And then here's where we will deviate. Let's use filter map. So this is going to be in case of any empty lines. So we'll pass in the author. Actually, we could just add the collect because we know we're going to collect at the end, right? And this is just where we'll handle the we'll remove the bit we don't want, so like we did before, author dot trim start matches. And then it's hyphen space at. So once we've got the author inside that little mini scope, then we can again do the if author, we'll do if is empty. Sorry, full stop there. If author is empty, then we'll do something else, we'll do something else, and then we'll, so if it's empty, just return none. Filter map is it allows you to collect stuff using obviously none or some, but and then the collect removes the sum for you. You see where we're going with this in a second. So sum, and then it's going to be author, and that's a string slice, so we do need to convert that to a string. So far so good. Let me just turn off the types. Okay, so what we've done there is we've taken the section, we've gone over each line, we've skipped the first line because that's the many thanks that we didn't want. And then we filtered it based on, well, we've removed the hyphen space at. If we had an empty line, we'd return none. Otherwise, we return or return it as author to string. So it's obviously this bit with that removed. And it's sum, but the collect actually. With filter map, collect will remove the sum, which we're about to see. So, and then because it's all done for us, we can just do for. It's already a iterator, lazy iterator. We can do for author in authors. We don't need the we don't need debug. Let me just pass in author here. So hopefully we won't get the sum at the start. Cool. So that's what we had before. So that's interesting because here we're passing sum, then the author to the string. But that sum is not appearing when we print it out. So collect is kind of collect and filter map have worked together, and we've got rid of the sum. We had to use the sum because is empty could either return none or sum. If it's empty, it returns nothing. If it's not empty, then it returns something, which is what it returns. So quite a lot to kind of think about there, but really, because it's a string separated by new lines, we can use dot lines. Skip one is quite intuitive. You just want to skip the first element. Filter map takes a bit more thinking about. So we filter map, pass in the author, which is kind of the name of the element that we're name of our iterable. And then we want to trim, so that's quite intuitive. This is maybe just needs a bit of thinking about. Just remember that you're getting a none or a sum there. And then just remember to collect it at the end. But once you do the functional style quite a few times, you'll remember you'll always go put collect. And you could do a turbo fish there if you wanted to do type inferencing, I think it's called. So here we go, and then we've got our iterator which authors, and then just for each thing inside the authors. Vec, it's a vec of strings. So for each one of those strings, we just print it here. Probably, if you want to copy this or make up your own version, obviously remove all that I've just highlighted. Just start with something like that. And then just have a think about how you could pass it, how you could end up with some keys. Well, that's like a type of key, and then that's your value. Arguably, you could use regular expressions in one line, but yeah, probably don't want to be doing that. So this is good practice as well, and it's good practice for thinking about how you can do kind of functional style programming, which is the strength of Rust. So thanks for watching, and thumbs up, like, subscribe, all the usual stuff, and I'll be back soon. Thank you.